How's it going? It's Mikey. And today we're going to talk about a fast and easy way to get the MTS 255 Golden in Call of Duty Ghosts. Now, if there is a particular shotgun or some other weapon that you want tips and tricks on how to get gold, just leave a comment below and I'll look through all of them, see what you guys want the most, and I'll get to work on it. So let's talk about this shotgun. Let's get to the chase. It is not a good weapon. It is not something you can just pick up and start beasting with. It is a little problem child here. It is a 5-round, like sort of like a revolver type, and it is just bad. I got this weapon gold, and I really don't think I'm gonna use it again. The only real reason to use this weapon is, yeah, it kind of looks cool, and or maybe you're just one of those people that wants to challenge yourself and get all golden weapons like I do. So let's get into the class setup. Now, these are just suggestions. This is what worked best for me. You are more than welcome to try something else. But in my opinion, I feel for this shotgun and all the shotguns, actually, the muzzle brake is a must. These are not shotguns from Black Ops 2 where you can borderline snipe people across the map. You know, remember the KSG? And, you know, the hipfire range is not like the Remington. They're all kind of bad. So the MTS, I feel you do need a muzzle brake and a foregrip. Now this shotgun, it does benefit the most when you ADS, aim down sights. You can get some kills hip firing, but really the style that is best for this weapon is an ADS, sort of like you're trying to quickscope people. You will get very good results aiming down your sights. So you notice that when you play with the shotgun, you have to sort of develop your whole class to that weapon. I have no secondary, no lethal, no tactical. Now you notice I only have 3 perks right there. These are the perks I feel are a must. Sleight of hand, a must, because the reload is so slow. Lightweight, although now it's called agility, it makes you move faster. And marathon, unlimited sprint. You have maybe 5 feet in front of you, very short range. You need to get into the enemy spawn as quickly as possible to get your kills, complete your challenges. Now, other than those 3 perks that I feel are a must, you can use all sorts of stuff. You will be getting a lot of assists. Hardline is good. Dead silence is really good because footsteps are so loud in this game. Quick draw is really good because you're using an ADS style of gameplay. Although I found that the MTS, it does have a very decent aim down sights time. And when I would run into people, I would usually take them out first if I was in range. All right, now on to the strike package. You will be dying a lot, so you might as well just get the support strike package. That way your kill streak does not reset. You'll be rushing a lot, trying to get into their spawn. Night Owl is amazing. It gives you a portable radar and it blocks explosives and missiles coming at you. It's really, really great. Ground Jammer is awesome. I would suggest waiting until you hear the announcer say enemy SATCOM. Then if you do it right there, not only do you take out their SATCOM, but you also get another point for that builds towards your streak. It's really awesome. It'll take down sentry guns, IMS. As long as you know that there is some type of equipment on the field, that is when you use it. Don't use it otherwise. You might as well use it to take down one of their streaks. And finally, the Oracle is awesome. Oracle sees all, well, almost all, and it really helps you and your teammates find those bad guys. If you're gonna be dying a lot, you might as well help your team. All right, so I said this is the class that I use most of the time. 90% of the time, that's the class you're gonna wanna use for all types of game types, domination, kill confirmed, blitz, TDM, whatever. But the exception is cranked. Now you see in cranked, once you get your first kill, you get all the speed perks. So there is no reason for you to have any of those. No sleight of hand, marathon, agility, forget it. Now for my perks, you see that they are very much different. No speed perks. Instead, I have an extra lethal and I have danger close on top of them just to increase my chances of getting a kill with them. And I do have hardline because yes, I'm still using a shotgun. So there's a good chance I'm probably not gonna live very long. All right, next let's talk the playlist. The playlist you want to be in is Ghost Mosh Pit. The reason for that is because 90% of the time people are picking Free Fall or Strike Zone, 2 very small maps, very fast paced, very good for your shotguns. all you want is small maps. You can attempt to get a golden shotgun on a large map. I have played a couple games on large maps, but it's not as fast. If you're looking for the fastest way, go Smosh Pit. All right, next up, let's talk challenges. Now, there are those that will happen naturally. You don't really need to do anything special. So let's get those out of the way. Autumn, 35 assists. Caustic, 3 kills and 1 life. Net, 500 kills. And Trail, 30 kills shortly after reload. All of those are going to happen on their own, especially the reload thing. You'll be reloading a lot with this MTS. So these you kind of don't really need to focus on. Now we do have a tricky one here. Ocean, 20 rescue kills. This one is kind of weird. You will need to change your playstyle. Sort of hang out in the middle of the map between your teammates and the other team. And basically what you got to do is catch someone as they're shooting your teammate. It's very tricky and it kind of happens randomly. We have body count and kiss of death. Those are for clans, clan challenges. You do not need to unlock those to get gold. Now next we have the challenges that are best if you work on them together. So first we got red, 50 kills, no attachments. Brush, 50 kills, crouch. Crocodile, 120 hipfire kills. Green, 120 point blank kills. And woodland, 35 kills shortly after sliding. All of these you should be doing at the exact same time. And the no attachments is definitely something that you should be working first on. See, here's the thing. If you're gonna be sliding around, why not slide right into somebody? Then you can get not only the point blank, you can hip fire them, you can stay crouched, and you can have no attachments. See, if you're sliding right into somebody and you have attachments on your weapon, that's sort of, you know, that's kind of pointless because you're gonna kill them if you're right up against them. You can go for a headshot, but we will get into that a little bit later. So I would highly recommend getting the no attachments challenge done right off the bat. And then once that's done, you can put on your foregrip and your muzzle brake. So honestly, those camos really aren't too hard to go for. But the one challenge that may give you the most trouble is scale. That is, get 40 headshots. But it really isn't that tough, more just time consuming. So here's my class. You want to have a whole new class. I still have the muzzle brake because I found I was still getting hit markers aiming for the head. And I do have a red dot sight just so I can make absolutely sure I am aiming at their head. You notice I do have a tactical this time, concussion. And for my perks, I have agility, marathon. I feel that those are a must for any shotgun user. And I have stalker. And you're gonna see I use this a lot. And this is gonna help you get into position so that way you can make sure you get that headshot. Dead silence, I feel, is a must in free for all. It's much more quiet, only 8 people in there, and you will notice that you can hear people stomping around. The footsteps are very loud in this game. And finally, I have an extra tactical. I want 2 stuns and strike package. You see, I have support. You're not going to be winning any free for all gameplays here, guys. And you just want the one thing that will help you, your SATCOM, and that's pretty much it. And so, your play style is really just be patient. Listen for people, and when you see somebody, you don't want to shoot them. You want to stun them, walk right up to them, and this is where Stalker helps so much. It really lets you get in there and aim and make sure you're aiming for the head, and then pop, and then they're dead. And that is why I have an extra on the tacticals. Maybe you'll get 1 kill, and so you have another tactical. It's not, you don't really need it, but it helps you so much, and it's going to help you really speed up the process of getting these headshots. Now again, this is just what worked best for me. You can play TDM, but I would recommend a much slower game type. The thing about free-for-all is it's just, you know, every single person is an enemy, only 8 people in there. It just makes it a lot easier on you. You can take your time when you're sneaking up on somebody. So that pretty much wraps it up. If you guys want me to work on a particular gun, just leave a comment below. If you want to play with me, just add me on Twitter, Facebook, links in the description. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. We're just going to talk about game modes. Now, this game isn't cut and dry, so I got 3 of the best game modes. So it's going to be up to you to decide what's the best for you. We got some, if you're an advanced player, some of you guys are brand new to this whole series. I got something for everybody, so let's just get into it. So first up, let's talk about the number one way to rank up. That is, if you are a complete beast and you're leveling up like crazy as it is, everybody knows this. Search and destroy.